In Appalachian Trail and through hiking culture, the word blaze takes on a pretty unique meaning. And no, stoners, I'm not talking about your meaning, 420 blaze at me. I'm talking about the various types of through hike blazing. The Appalachian Trail is marked in its entirety by painted on white blazes, which is where all this blazing talk comes from in the first place. For example, there's something called blue blazing, which is when you take a side trail instead of the main white blaze trail. There's also something called pink blazing, which is when a hiker intentionally alters their hiking pace in order to stick around a potential love interest, which is kind of fucking weird. And then there's the topic of this video, the controversial practice of yellow blazing, which means to skip sections of the Appalachian Trail while still maintaining that you are through hiking. And the reason it's called yellow blazing is because it references the yellow lines in the center of the road, which is what people who skip sections of the trail inevitably end up following instead of the actual white blazes on the trail. Now, in most of my videos, I'm usually all over the place. I'm joking around a lot, I'm having a good time, but for some reason, this topic just felt like it needed to be covered in a more basic way. So what I did is I went out into my backyard, I pressed record on my camera as the sun started to blast me in the face, and then I just spilled my guts on this subject. What I ended up with is a raw, candid take on the controversial subject of yellow blazing, of course, coming from the perspective of someone who actually hiked the entire Appalachian Trail. The Appalachian Trail has a problem, or I guess it's not the trail itself, but the Appalachian Trail community, particularly the thru-hiking community, has a problem, and nobody really seems to talk about it that much. This problem is yellow blazing. Some people call that cheating, some people call that just hiking your own hike, doing whatever the hell you want to do because it doesn't really matter. Either way, we're going to talk about all sides of the argument today. We're going to break down the arguments for why it's okay. We're going to break down the arguments for why it's not okay. And by the end of the video, which you have to watch all the way through, by the way, we're going to get to the question of whether or not yellow blazing really is a problem in the first place, and if it is, what we can do about it. So if you've never seen one of my videos before, hello. My name's Kyle. I hate hiking. It f***ing sucks. I thru-hiked the Appalachian Trail in 2018, which I guess is kind of old news by now, but still it's an experience I hold very near and dear to my heart, given I'm still freaking blabbing about it 3 years later. And before my Appalachian Trail thru-hike, I knew what yellow blazing was, but I didn't really realize how common it actually is. I really just assumed it was like a small, like very rare group of people that were doing it. And it was something that unfortunately was on my mind a lot while I was through hiking the Appalachian Trail. Now, that being said, I don't really like worry about it now that I'm off the AT. Obviously, I'm not like f***ing staying up at night like, oh my God, people yell. Like, no, like, it's not that big a deal now. But while I was out there, it really did bug me. And that's one thing I want to make clear right from the start here. The point of this video is not to just like shit all over yellow blazers for 10 minutes. That sounds gross. I'm not going to do that, but I do want to be clear about my bias. I'm going to try to represent both sides of the yellow blazing debate. But for me personally, I was not a fan of yellow blazing. I'm still not a fan of yellow blazing, and I never yellow blazed at all. This is all based off of my experience. I will say I started really, really late in the season. When I went northbound, I started on May 14th, 2018. And as a result, I was kind of like catching up to people as I went. I kind of caught like the tail end of the bubble of northbound thru hikers. And I think because I was hiking at like the end of the bubble, I was catching up to probably more yellow blazers than people might see if they start earlier or just at a normal time to do a northbound thru hike. So I want to define what yellow blazing is and isn't, at least just for the sake of this video, because obviously this is all just bullshit hiker term stuff. Like, there's no actual definition. Like, you're not gonna go to Webster's dictionary and find like a fucking definition for yellow blazing. Urban Dictionary has one though. I don't care who you are, I don't care how good of a hiker you are, it's hard to put 2,100 whatever miles of continuous hiking together without skipping anything at all. And as a result, a lot of people who really are doing their due diligence to hike the entire trail still end up maybe missing like a mile or two here and there, or like a section or two here and there or whatever. And I want to be clear,
I'm not really talking about those people in this video, because I think everybody can understand that it's pretty reasonable to like maybe have to miss like a little bit of the trail every now and then just due to like circumstances out of your control. For instance, I remember talking to a thru-hiker who was getting a shuttle back to the trail from like a hostel owner, like some sort of business. They didn't realize it when they got in the car, but they were actually being dropped off at a different trailhead that was just like a couple miles away from the one they came in on. And it's like, in that circumstance, technically, like they ended up missing a few miles because of it, but I think most reasonable people aren't gonna like force that shuttle driver to go out of their way when they're the ones that kind of made the mistake or just the miscommunication of getting into the car in the first place. However, not all cases of yellow blazing are as forgiving, in my opinion, again, because I found on my Appalachian Trail thru-hike, there was a lot of people who were saying that they were thru-hiking, they were staying at the shelters and the campsites that thru-hikers are staying at, but they were consistently skipping sections of the trail. The reason I knew a lot of these people were skipping is because I would pass them and like I wouldn't see them for a few days. And you know, after a while out there, you get like a pretty good idea of what your pace is. And generally speaking, if you're hiking at a similar pace to somebody, after a few days, you'll probably start to see each other quite a bit. You'll be leapfrogging each other. And it's easy to tell who's hiking at the same pace you are. A lot of these people I would pass and I would not see them for a few days after that, sometimes a few weeks even. And then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, I would usually get to a town or a hostel, something like that, and magically, poof, there they were again. And like I said, I'm gonna try to give them the benefit of the doubt and give their perspective, maybe the arguments that they would have used against me if I had talked to them about this in just a few minutes. But first, I really wanna kinda go over my case for why I do not like yellow blazing and why I really wish that people wouldn't, you know, yellow blaze. I think one of the biggest reasons why I didn't and still don't like it is because it really kind of distorts the meaning of the term thru-hike, right? Because essentially at the end of the day, you're taking credit for the same thing that these people are taking credit for when you complete a thru-hike, when you tell people that you thru-hiked the Appalachian Trail, for instance. And I know that sounds kind of superficial. That sun feels amazing on my face right now. It's freezing out here. But at the end of the day, like I put like so much into that thru-hike. So even if it's just a personal accomplishment, it means a lot to me. The title of thru-hiker really, really means a lot. And to share that with people who I know for a fact, like I don't really remember anybody specifically at this point, but to share that with people who I know didn't actually do the entire trail and didn't even really try to do the entire trail, that makes me a little bit upset. And again, it doesn't really matter. And I'm gonna talk about this in just a second, but when you really care about the Appalachian Trail, when you care about the integrity of thru hiking, it does matter. It does matter to me. And I know it matters to a lot of you guys as well. Before I left for the Appalachian Trail, it never occurred to me that somebody would go out there, regularly skip sections of the trail, and still say that they're thru hiking the Appalachian Trail, still call themselves thru hikers, and still kind of take credit for it. That never occurred to me, because for me, it was always about the hike. It was always about completing the goal. But for a lot of these other people, that really wasn't what it was about. It was more about, you know, the experience and those things. And that's fine. You know, I still had an amazing experience, but I always thought of it as a hike. I always thought of it as trying to complete a hike, a hiking goal, I guess you could say. I never thought of it as just a vacation. I never thought of it as just a journey. With that being said, I want to be fair here. Accomplishing a thru hike is like a personal accomplishment. I think everyone would agree that if you're trying to set like an FKT or something like that, then obviously like you can't be skipping sections of the trail. That's just blatantly cheating. But I wasn't setting an FKT. I wasn't even close. I wasn't even trying to. I was just trying to hike the entire trail for me. I was trying to thru-hike the Appalachian Trail for me. So why does it matter what somebody else does? Another thing you have to think about is the Appalachian Trail is available for more uses than just thru-hiking. For every thru-hiker, there's got to be at least 10, 20, maybe even more people who use the trail or parts of the trail for day hiking and section hiking. So if people are obviously going to be allowed to go use the trail for those things, then does it really matter like who did it, like the entire trail versus who might have skipped a little bit here and there? Like, you're all using the same trail. You're all part of the same community. So why does that really matter? And in my opinion, the most compelling argument for yellow blazing against people who, like me, you know, don't really want people to yell blaze is that there's really no true definition of a thru-hike. Like, who gets to decide, you know, what exactly constitutes a thru-hike and what doesn't? We all really have our own personal definitions. And for me, my idea of a thru-hike is hiking the entire trail, but I don't get to decide that for everybody else. I don't make the rule. The closest thing we have to like an official definition is the definition from the Appalachian Trail Conservancy, which oversees and maintains and protects most of the Appalachian Trail. The ATC, and this is straight from their website, by the way, defines a thru-hike as hiking the entire Appalachian Trail in 12 months or less. That's it. That's their definition. So it does say in that definition you have to hike the entire trail. But at the end of the day, all that is a sentence on a website. And of course, the ATC does have a lot of say with the Appalachian Trail. The ATC is what represents the Appalachian Trail. But I don't know. They're not even recognizing people's thru hikes this year or last year. So I don't know if we can just give them all of the credit to just like make the official definition for what constitutes an Appalachian Trail thru hike. So all of this kind of funnels into the question of, is yellow blazing okay? Is it acceptable? And what can we do about it? And as much as I'd like to think that I'm smart and important enough to make a definitive answer to those questions, I'm not. I'm kind of an idiot and I'm just one person. So I'm gonna call on you in the comment section right now to answer those questions for yourself. In my opinion, obviously, I don't think yellow blazing is okay, and I would urge anybody who does a thru hike to please do your due diligence and make your best effort to hike the entire trail. Again, I'm not gonna bust your balls if you skip a mile or two here and there, but I really think the Appalachian Trail is an amazing thing. We're extremely fortunate to have this in our country, and I think if you're gonna say you're gonna, if you say you're gonna thru hike, like, do your best to hike the entire trail. I don't think you're gonna regret it either. I think it's actually gonna enhance your experience quite a bit. I care about the Appalachian Trail. I care about the integrity of thru hiking, and that's why I hold that opinion. And as far as what we can do about it, the answer is, I don't know. I mean, that's not really an answer, but I don't wanna make it into like a really big deal either. So I'm not saying at all that you should go out and you should like call out people for yell blazing. You should like start confrontations and arguments about it while you're on trail. Don't do those things. Mind your own business. I really wanted to when I was out there before. I was pretty close to doing it a couple times, but I don't think I ever did, which I'm glad, because it's just not worth the argument. Like, just be a nice person. Treat everybody as an individual. At the end of the day, I think really the only thing that we can do to kind of like push back against the trend of yellow blazing and to maybe kind of change the culture a little bit or try to influence the culture is just be proud that you hiked the whole trail, or be proud that your goal is to hike the whole trail. And honestly, that's really it, because at the end of the day, it's not like this is such a big deal that it's worth, you know, really dividing the community over. It's not worth starting a bunch of arguments over it. I'm really looking forward to the comments section on this one. I feel like it could be a little controversial. We'll see. If you guys enjoyed this video, I would really appreciate it if you subscribed. Most people who watch my videos are not subscribed, so check to make sure you're subscribed to Kyle Hates Hiking. If you're not, hit the subscribe button, ring the notification bell, and thank you for watching. And unless you didn't like it, kind of weird. Kind of a weird way to end a video. I'm freezing.